Today on Screen It or Stream It.
You know, it is really true what they say, the clothes make the man.
So, what does it make us?
Well, obviously, we are of the finest caliber.
Aw, I was going for hobo.
All right, so we've got our top five picks each, our favorite costumes. For me, for my list, I am excluding suits that are intended to create like a creature. So like the Xenomorph from Alien or something. I wouldn't count that as a costume specifically, but it is a great costume, but just for me to narrow it down to more wardrobe-y things is kind of what I wanted to do. And I'm also excluding, by extension, no full body prosthetics or anything like that. And no CGI. I'm not even thinking about CGI costumes because, I was about to say it's lazy. It's not. I'm sure they're hard to make, but it's just, to me, it's a different sort of thing. May have a category for that someday. How about you?
I don't think I had rules like that, but I definitely don't have any CGI ones in there. And I definitely have an aesthetic that will be apparent. Most of mine are, you know, high fantasy, sci-fi type things, but that's what I like.
They so
just my favorite costumes are places that are costumes that take me to places and put me in that world.
Well, I could see that, and they do certainly lend themselves well to creating an environment when they've got, you know, that much freedom to play with and create a whole world of fashion, essentially. Even though I'm not a fashion-y kind of person, you could probably tell. So, what's your number five, or do you want me to go first?
I'll go first, it's fine. So, my number five is kind of fantasy, and it's not the it's pretty much the only like historical, like actual maybe could have existed type costume, and that's Gladiator.
My movie is
Gladiator, and because while the, you know, Russell Crowe and the main character, he just doesn't, for the most part, he's usually a slave and doesn't wear a lot of stuff, but some of the villains in this had these beautiful ornate pieces and just the whole thing just kind of won me over. And I really, when I was trying to think, I was trying to think of something historical. I love, you know, a lot of the, like, Braveheart and, well, pretty much any of those Mel Gibson, like, historical things, like The Patriot and things like that. And I love the costumes in there. But to me, they did a great job in those movies of making costumes that look like what they should look like. And so then there's just not, like, how do you differentiate? Oh, hey, we made the same suit somebody made 200 years ago.
Old hat.
But Gladiator, to me, it kind of kept the aesthetic that was there, but then it kind of stepped it up a notch and went a little extravagant at times. And it just really made neat costumes for me.
Plus, all-star cast in that one. You had Russell Crowe and Richard Harris playing the older emperor, and Joaquin Phoenix playing the, was it Commodus, I think is his name? I don't remember. It's been a while since I've seen it, but yeah, great movie, great costumes. I think the most memorable one for me out of that was when he was in the gladiator pit with the kind of armor, and that helmet was very kind of iconic. All right, for me, my number five, Indiana Jones. Do I even need to say anything else? Like, when you think adventurer, like, do I need to say anything else? He's got the hat, the jacket, the whip, I mean, iconic.
I thought you were going to talk about Short Round. You mean...
Very funny. Very funny, Dr. Jones. Which, oddly enough, my favorite line from the first three was delivered by Short Round. They were on the rope bridge, remember? And he's threatening to cut it. And he says something in Chinese to Short Round. And the lady, I don't remember her name, said, "What'd he say?" And he starts grabbing around the edges. He says, "Hang on, lady. We going for a ride." That's a good movie. Temple of Doom. So,
yeah, I really did enjoy Indiana Jones. Like, the costumes are good. It's hilarious that wasn't Harrison Ford's. Like, it was supposed to be Tom Selleck, and they had to remake the costume at the last second.
I did not know
that.
No.
So they wanted Tom Selleck to be Indiana Jones, and they had made the costumes for him.
Wow.
And so then Harrison Ford showed up, like, at the last minute. I forget what happened. But because Harrison Ford is not of the same stature, let's say, of Tom Selleck, nothing fit, nothing worked, and they had to do kind of a mad dash. But that is one of those iconic, like, especially Indy's outfit. Like, you could just put that outfit somewhere, and most of the world should know
what that is. Highly recognizable. And And also seems like you could use it for all kind of different things. It's because it's not, but it's kind of that, it's the adventuresome thing. It just rugged and...
So my number four is not really so much for a specific costume as more as an entire world building. And actually quite a few of mine are based on, hey, we built a world for you. But it's Star Wars.
Oh, yeah.
And I mean, while there were some really neat costumes, even some of the prequel ones had...
Yeah.
Really nice, you know, costumes, and Princess Amidala had all the stuff. But, you know, I guess individually if I look at them, like, the Jedi robes aren't really that fancy, you know. But, again, they have become almost a...
Almost iconic themselves.
Right. That's a Jedi. Mm-hmm. And then, you know, the Darth Vader, which I don't know if that violates your creature.
No, that was actually on my number three.
Okay. But yeah, so then the Darth Vader, like, everybody should know who that is. And it's such an... And then the Stormtroopers.
Oh my gosh, yeah.
And like, so just all the costuming around just built this world. And they did a great job to me of, because you have the Rebel Alliance and you have the Empire, and then the costuming makes it easy to discern at a quick glance, you know. The Empire, everything is so clean and so like meticulously done, but it's also so like sterile and kind of plasticky and metallic-y and like machinery. And then you go to the Rebel Alliance and it's got a little dirt on it, and it's very, they're like cottons and stuff, so it's very like natural fibers, and it, you know, it helps create even more of a divide there. And I thought that was a great use of costumes to, you know, accentuate things in a movie rather than take away from it.
Well, and plus they did a lot of earthy colors for the Rebels. Do a lot of camouflage too because they're trying to hide. But I mean, it still, that lends itself to making that difference.
Yeah, most of the Empires are very stark. Like it's
black, white,
red, you know, and it stands out and it grabs you. Mm-hmm. But yeah, so I always thought that was a great piece of world building through costume.
Well, another one of my favorites, my number four, is Stardust, which has a huge world of costuming, from the pirates to all the princes with their like flowing things, and of course the one guy ended up naked, which was pretty funny. But that was that's a funny movie. If you haven't seen it, it's just it's quirky and weird and kind of has a charm that you don't find often. But the costume that really drew me to it initially was the main character, Tristan, at the end. He was wearing like this white duster thing. He just looked sharp. he looked quite heroic, and that just really drew me to the movie. And it's just, again, from the witches with their like hag costumes, and of course the star who had that like flowing, it was just a good world built of costumes. Not nearly as iconic as Star Wars, not even close, but it was a world all its own, and it's well done.
That was a movie I like passed over when it came to theaters. It didn't look good.
Yeah, I think we caught it on disc later.
Yeah, I think it was probably Netflix disc years and years ago. And it looked like something my wife would like, and that's why I got it. And then she wouldn't watch it. She's like, oh, this is stupid. And I'm like, that's so totally you. And so I'm like, well, I got it. I'm watching it. And I love that. It was just a great... It really reminded me of those high fan, like almost Princess Bride or Labyrinth or something like that. Not quite that level. Mm-hmm. Like it was missing a little bit of something, but definitely really close to that. And it's closest thing I've gotten in a long time to those.
Which when I think of a movie, charming is not a word I use to describe movies often. But The Princess Bride is the one that comes to mind. If a movie is charming, that's like the first one I think of. Stardust is another one, and the first Pirates of the Caribbean is another one that just has a charm to it that you just... It's a rare thing to find that.
And Pirates of the Caribbean came out of nowhere.
Yeah.
Like it just... boom.
And I don't feel like the second one kind of did, but after that, the charm was gone, for me at least.
Well,
I'm not saying they're bad, but they did not have that charm that made me like the first one the way that I like it.
That's true.
Not knocking the sequels. They're okay. They're fun.
Yeah, they just don't have that magic that the first ones did. My number three, again, sci-fi. It's going to be Fifth Element.
Ooh.
And like, if you want specifics, I loved the... Well, first of all, I love the use of... When you make a costume and it's things you'd never seen before or never even imagined, and you know, and sometimes they can take a piece of something and glue it onto somebody or glue it onto an outfit, and you make something unique looking, and you're like, oh, it's a you know, it's a handle off a flashlight, and you know, I never would have thought of that.
Yeah, and it just works.
And it just works. But at the same time, you know, the Fifth Element, to me, they created so many unique things and in ways I would have never had never seen before and had never put together. So I really like the policeman's outfits, and they have the weird helmets. I thought that was great. Leeloo's outfits, Corbin's outfits, and then
Chris Tucker
as Ruby Rod. And, and to fit that in this universe and just this garish, you know, outfits that he has, and it fits his personality so perfectly. Everybody's outfit kind of fits their personalities, and I thought that was great. But really, Zorg, and he's got the thing on his head, and it's so weird, and the accent is great, and it just all around, I love it. And actually, and I just blanked on the director's name, but he did, you know, Valerian in this Thousand Planets,
Luke
Besson or something like that. But he. Like, pretty much any of his movies, like, aesthetically, and again, like...
Well, even Valerian aesthetically looked cool.
Great, yeah, and so any of his movies could kind of be wrapped up in that for me, but Fifth Element is my favorite of them easily, so I'm going Fifth Element.
So I think I may actually throw one that was not even on my list, which is kind of a shame because I love all of these too, but the...
we can do honorable ones.
Along that same lines, The Hunger Games... was really, and I feel like I want to say they were inspired by Star Wars. I don't know what they were actually inspired by, but since their peacekeepers were all white, reminds me of Stormtroopers a lot, and then everyone else was dirty and gritty and grimy, like the Rebel Alliance kind of. Again, not saying they were inspired by that, but it looks like a parallel. But more specifically, Caesar Flickerman always had the crazy costumes, the showman guy, and again, that whole world. So I'm going with that for my number three, that because you got Star Wars from me.
Because he told me to go first.
They just had so many different, and fashion was actually a really important part of that movie, because the whole thing, especially the first one, was for the show, and so they're showing off everybody, but they always had Jennifer Lawrence as Katniss Everdeen dressed in something that was to show off, you know, and make her the Mockingjay or whatever. Mm-hmm. So that one was really high on costumes too. So Hunger Games.
All right, my number two is Batman, but it's the Tim Burton Batman. If I had to be specific, I would pick Batman Returns, probably as my favorite, like, costume-wise. And again, I know it's a weird thing, but it's totally my aesthetic. And it came out in, I can't remember if Returns came out in the late 80s or early 90s.
The Returns would have been early 90s, early 90s. Because the first one was 1989. 88, 89. It was right in there.
So... But back then, like nowadays, there's so much like dark stuff, right?
Right.
But back then, you didn't get...
It wasn't common, yeah.
Right, and then Tim Burton comes out with this stuff, and it's like, what on earth am I looking at? But it was so different. I love it. And probably my favorite costume is the Penguin. And it's gross. It's so gross, and it's so terrible. But I like the costume because... I had never seen anything that gross and that terrible, like not in a horror movie before. But I really like overall, again, and Tim Burton, his like world building for me is great. Yeah. It doesn't matter if he's doing, you know, Sleepy Hollow or Batman. Like mm-hmm. I always enjoy mm-hmm. his world building or even the animated ones. But everything just is so, so dark and so nasty. And it just has this kind of like dark twist to it. Even, you know, the Batman suit itself, we have the all black with the yellow logo, and that was the first time we'd gotten away from really Adam West's like 66
the
Batman
blue and gray,
with his blue and gray and just everything. And then you had Jack Nicholson as the Joker, and we've got the purple suit and the tie, mm-hmm. and it's just, oh, it was just great. And Catwoman in the stitched together like leather outfit,
that one was, I've never seen a better Catwoman costume. That one was just amazing.
Michelle Pfeiffer's, yeah.
And she filled it nicely. I mean...
Well, I mean, if you gotta look at it, it's...
Yeah. They were working with what they had, and they made the absolute best that could have been made with what they were doing. They did a good job. The costume just looked great.
Well, and to go back to, like, Danny DeVito's, there was literally times when, like, I didn't... It was so... When he's like eating the fish and he has like a black bile and it's all down the front of him and you just don't even want to look at it. And I think to me the costume is so great because it was Danny DeVito. Mm-hmm. And I'm not talking about like his acting and portrayal. But it's Danny DeVito. Mm-hmm. If you picture him, he's the like funny guy, and he's always doing something silly. And especially back then, like everything he had done was kind of silly and kind
of Twins and yeah, throw mama from the train,
and it's all kind of slapstick. Yeah. And then all of a sudden he comes out, and I mean, you are he is repulsive, mm-hmm. and you know, and to do that to him. To me, it took a lot of skill and amazing, you know, ability and talent to go, how do we take this? And I know it's about costumes, but I also love all the other stuff too. So like the rubber duck and the umbrellas and like everything that kind of goes along with
those are accessories.
The accessories to his costume. What's your accessory? Oh, I have a giant 4x4 rubber duck with stilts. It's great.
All right, where are we on number two?
Number two.
My number two is Willow. Wait, no, it isn't. Yes, it is.
We're too late now. You said it.
I said it. It's too late. Willow. Again, high fantasy is just kind of a gimme for standing out for costume-wise. And there's a lot of good costumes in that movie, from the guy with the skull mask who was riding around killing people. Of course, 1988, Val Kilmer, Warwick Davis, and I forget everybody else, but there are a lot of fun stuff in there. It's one of... it was related to George Lucas, but it was a Ron Howard movie. It was one of his first like movies, and loved Val Kilmer as Mad Mardigan, the greatest swordsman the world has ever seen. And I loved the armor they found at the abandoned castle. He was like in this gold plate armor with the, and it just he looked like a proper hero, just going around killing stuff and fought a dragon, two-headed dragon. Why not? And in the 80s too, so no CGI, some stop motion that may not have held up too well effects wise, but great story. It's just, it is a proper fun high fantasy story, so it's a good movie, good costumes.
No, and I love that movie. It's such mm-hmm. a great movie. So many great little characters and pieces. Ooh, I said little characters. I didn't mean it.
There's a lot of short people in that movie.
Stupid Becky. All right, number one.
Number one.
And we're going to have to do honorable mentions because I've got way too many. I left a lot of stuff too. But my number one, and this is, like, I knew immediately when you said costumes, I know what my favorite costumes are, and they're probably not going to be anybody else's. But it's Mad Max.
Oh, yeah.
And, like, I just love that, like, dystopian aesthetic and the, like, desert wasteland warrior thing. And in the original Mad Max... he's a police officer, and the costumes really aren't, you know, outstanding as far as... I mean, they're okay. They work for what they are, but there's nothing super special about them.
Just the biker punks, kind
of. Well, but the biker punks were biker punks they found somewhere and gave them a case of beer and said, hey, come be in our movie, wear your clothes, and this is what they had on when they showed up. Which is an amazing piece of, you know, of costuming in itself. You guys look awesome. Come be in my movie.
Life imitating art.
But yeah, and so in Mad Max, he starts off as a police officer, and then mm-hmm. you know, tragedy happens, and he goes from Max Rokitansky, the police officer, to Mad Max, and then we get the kind of dystopian, and it's all pieced together out of junk, and that's what I love about it. It's just mm-hmm. which, you know, as you go on, you go to you know, the Road Warrior and Thunderdome, and then Fury Road, you get those. It's just like scavenged, right? It's armor and pieces and bits and whatever. It's old tires and the shoulder pad. It's just great. And again, to me, there's some very iconic mm-hmm. characters there. But between, I mean, Max, of course, is a star. But if you want to go forward, you got Furiosa and the new one. Go back and you've got Lord Humongous, and he's got the like weird S&M gear, but he's got the metal hockey mask, and that was just like frightening, and he's got the voice and the head with just the wisp of hair, and I don't know, but to me, like, if I could walk around wearing, you know, armor and stuff all day long, I'd be great.
Well, my number one then, I'm going with 1984 Dune, from the like very polished like dress, whatever they had, looked kind of like Navy Admirals or something, of House Atreides, to the just creepy Baron Harkonnen stuff, to the still suits they wore out in the desert. Just a lot of fun costumes to look at, and surprisingly, like the still suits specifically looked so practical, like that would be a real thing you could really wear that would work, but I don't think they actually exist. but it's such a neat, just a lot of neat stuff to look at, and of course, I've heard from a lot of the purists that read the books and say, oh, that movie's terrible, you need to read the book. Okay, sure, but the movie's fun to look at. Maybe not close enough to the book, but it's a lot of fun to look at. And from also the, like, priestesses or whatever, the Bene Gesserit or whatever they're called, have the, like, weird flowing robes and, of course, the creepy fingernails. And getting into makeup now, but still, it's just a lot of neat stuff to look at, a lot of good costuming. Plus Patrick Stewart with a little tiny pug. I mean, what's not to like? The pug was actually the best costume accessory because he's running through the desert with a little pug. Like, what is that? I don't know.
So, I know there are movies out there that I actually like. Mm-hmm. Like, I could look at that and go, oh, that was better costume design or better costumes. But I tried to pick movies that I thought were greatly enhanced by those costumes. Mm-hmm. Some of the movies that have great costumes, I think, would have worked with or without it.
Yeah.
And I mean, like, Star Wars is a fantastical thing, but I thought that, like, the costumes did so much to add to the movie. I think, you know, Mad Max, it's pretty much in a desert. If they didn't have the cars and the costumes, it would just be a bunch of guys in the desert. And so, I know I've left off a lot of stuff. There's probably a lot of stuff I didn't think of. So let's talk about some, like, honorable mentions.
Some honorable mentions. Oh, yeah, we got a little time. Scream, 1996.
So that's hilarious.
The Killer Mask.
Actually thought that one.
And I don't know, because the movie's okay. I mean, it's all right. But that Killer Mask is so creepy. Well done, guys. That was awesome.
And again, it was something we had never... I mean, it's been imitated a million times now, but it was so original and so unique at that point.
But that's why it's been imitated, was because it was awesome.
Excalibur.
Oh, yeah.
The armor in Excalibur is just amazing. And that really probably... Like, if you asked for the, like, favorite costume of all time, it might be, like, Lancelot or King Arthur's armor from... Excalibur.
So shiny.
But again, it's a little stylized to it, but just it was so well done. But again, it was very, you know, period armor. Well,
it was anachronistic, but it's okay.
Well, but it's fine.
We'll
it's
take
King
it.
Arthur. I mean, it's kind of a fantasy story.
Yeah, it's high fantasy. Just go with it.
But and then that also kind of fits into, like I said, Braveheart and, you know, the Patriot and stuff like that, because... Oh, they didn't wear kilts back then. They're supposed to have pants. But but that row of guys in the kilts mooning everybody doesn't work, you know, as well.
That's true.
With the pants. And so...
Which I was told, too, that when the Scotsmen would go out to battle like that at that time, they would fight naked. So you could still moon people, I guess. But, I mean, it's still... There's something about the kilt lifting that just really makes that scene.
So I wonder something, because, like, you know, the Maori warriors, like, do the... like tattoos and stuff, because it's supposed to make them look terrifying, and they do, you know.
Well, that's what the blue paint was about. Yeah, it was a ritualistic thing to,
you're supposed
protect
to scare,
them.
Right,
and
you scare
people.
If I had to fight a bunch of naked guys, I'd probably.
I'd be concerned.
It made me think twice as the camera.
Don't fight those guys, they're crazy.
Something wrong with them.
Well, I put Aliens on my list for an honorable mention. I think it was the Colonial Marine costume just looked cool.
Yeah.
Of course, again, breaking my own rule, the Xenomorph was just freaking amazing. It's one of the coolest things ever, but again, that was not part of my thing.
Well, and you got things, again, and I don't know how much that's, you know, is it a costume or a creature, but like RoboCop. And,
oh, yeah.
Like the original RoboCop and the great, RoboCop outfit.
Yeah, that armor...
But like I said, I kind of leaned towards world building, and like while I thought RoboCop costume was awesome, there wasn't really anything else in there costume wise. It just stood out because it was kind of contemporary at that point.
Yeah, they're all right, but they just were kind of plain.
The Princess Bride.
That was on my list. Yeah, I love the Princess Bride. Wesley in his black Dread Pirate Roberts, he just looked cool. Of course, even Mandy Patinkin, I can never pronounce that, in his Inigo Montoya.
Andre the Giant is Fezzik, and it's such a basic, such basic,
it's so simple,
stuff,
but it fits. It works perfectly. Of course, Buttercup had all the dresses. I think the red one was probably the best one.
Wallace Shawn is
Sicilian. A lot of good stuff. And Humperdinck. All his crushed velvet.
Humperdinck. And then you've got, so I completely forgot about Billy Crystal.
The Miracle Max.
Miracle Max,
love it. And Carol Kane.
But yeah, you can probably go back and point to any like high fantasy I mean, because a lot of the high fantasy is about the costuming and the world that it's around. I mean, something like The Wizard of Oz.
Oh, yeah.
Like Dorothy's iconic dress and the ruby slippers mm-hmm. and, you know, and again, it kind of goes into creatures, but the Tin Man and the Cowardly Lion and the Scarecrow and like all that. And then all the like umpteenth iterations of, you know, The Wizard of Oz and sequels yeah. and prequels and whatever. My favorite is Return to Oz.
Oh, yeah, and that one's like, just creepy. The Wheelers. Oh, my gosh, they're so scary. Princess Mumby. Oh, is that a costume thing since she changes her heads?
I don't know. Is it counts as a costume if you take your head off and replace it with somebody else's?
I don't like that. Ah, that one head was really scary. They were all scary, but that one was particularly scary. Just that had the eyes and the...
yeah.
The Karate Kid has got to be my favorite honorable mention. Because they had a literal costume party, which kind of made this a bit funny, a little tongue-in-cheek, I guess. But he was dressed as a shower. Who does that, first of all? But that's a great costume, because he's completely closed up. He don't want to talk to anybody, just pulls the curtain. So, but the... Just had a lot of good costumes, and I don't think his gi was iconic, really.
Nothing really special about it, yeah.
He had the bandana, though, and that made it...
The bandana is iconic, the gi
yeah.
is not.
Yeah. But anyway, that's all our time, unless you got anything else.
No, that's it.
Well, thank you so much for watching Screen Reader Stream It.
And remember, don't take your kids to the movies on Tuesday nights, because that's when we go.
Thanks for hanging with us.
You made it all the way to the end. Congratulations. I hope you enjoyed our list of our top 10 costumes. I know we forgot stuff.
Oh, yeah.
I know you probably disagree with us. Then leave a comment below. Let us know what's your favorite costume, favorite movies of costumes.
Or even TV series, because we didn't even touch those.
Yeah,
and like Game of Thrones or whatever have just amazing, amazing art design and costume design. And there's just such a wonderful and rich world of stuff. So yeah, tell us what you think.